Denis Napthine has a few more hard days left on the campaign trail ahead of Saturday's election in Victoria. Studio 10's probing reporter Libbi Gorr has uncovered a different side to him when she spoke with the Premier and his wife Peggy.
What an opportunity.
Hello, how are you?
To the Premier. I've got your family up there.
Yeah, that's terrific.
Keeping up with all the action, are you?
Yeah, keeping up with all the action.
So you got to sleep well.
Yeah. I was just telling a story when I was in here last buying a dress for a lady. Was here.
Were you? Yeah. Oh, not for yourself.
No, not for myself.
Okay.
Does he often buy you clothes, Mrs. Napthine?
No, he doesn't buy me clothes, no. He doesn't even buy his own clothes. Who buys his clothes? I know, so his clothes.
I contract
that
out.
I'm not sure I should be saying that. Some people might be making a judgment that perhaps he should be better dressed, but anyway, we do our best, don't we?
I think he looks good. I think that the blue, it does.
Yeah, it's blue suits him. Yeah.
Sorry. Oh, sorry. <That's>
I apologise.
Harvey, how are you? I'm a vet in my previous life.
No, yeah. Take him home.
And you know, he is a vet, so he's good with dealing with animals.
Yeah.
And that possibly makes you an ideal candidate for politics.
Good deal with dealing with animals and people. And,
yeah.
You know, I love people. I absolutely love people. I'll go up to strangers and say hello and, you know, most people are warm and welcoming. Some people are not so welcoming, but you just take it in your stride, you move on. Just enjoy life.
You're allowed to euthanise animals that are past their youths by date. What about politicians? How do you get rid of the ones that...
Well, people vote them out.
And you're in favour of that?
Well, people are... Democracy is a wonderful thing.
To lead, do you need age or do you need freshness and verve?
I think you need a bit of experience, but mostly you need an understanding of Victoria. And I love Victoria. I love every piece of Victoria, whether it's Mallacoota or Mildura, whether it's Warrnambool or Wodonga. You need to understand Victoria, both the city, our beautiful, most livable city in the world, Melbourne, and our beautiful regional cities and our country areas.
Do you think your dad's a bit bonkers, Tom?
Oh, I think you need to be a little bit eccentric to go into politics. I think you need that. I think that's good. And I think Dad has that in all the right areas. He just absolutely loves people and he works himself into the ground. The other guys at the office, I'll dob them in, they say that they can't keep up with Dad and they're half his age.
He's been trained well.
He is.
And when Dr. Napthine does his big speeches and stuff, have you perfected, Peggy, the listening and agreeing? Because you know the person that's...
Afterwards, I give him the assessment about how I think it...
Really?
You know, where it rated, you know. We always rate the speeches, don't we?
Yeah, it's out of 10.
And are you a hard marker or a good marker?
I'm a fairly hard marker because, you know, I've heard a lot of speeches.
Who's the Premier in your house?
Peg runs the garden, the house, she runs everything like that.
What about your life plan?
I think the dogs and the cats are real.
I think that's absolutely right.
They keep you grounded and I guess we could all do with a bit of wag in our tail.
That's right. And I mean, one thing about having dogs, and as a vet I can champion this, that having dogs keeps you fitter, improves your mental health. It really is a great investment is to buy a dog because they always love you. No matter what else you do, they always love you.
You don't always feel loved, Mr. Premier.
Well, sometimes we need love from somebody whose love is absolutely unconditional.
You can't always be dependent upon what they say at the ballot box.
That's right. Always look on the
bright side of life. My kids had the biggest collection of stuffed animals and I think Tom was about 12 before I convinced him that we could get rid of some of them. And
she's dobbing me in here because she still buys. There's a polar bear on my table at home and there's a singing pillow that sings Always Look on the Bright Side of Life. Pretty much every time I get dumped by a girlfriend, Mum goes out and buys something at the op shop.
How old are you?
24.
24. Peggy.
I'll buy you a green Smurf.
All right.
Right, eh?
I'll have to declare it, of course. It's my little Smurf. What's his name? Dennis.
Dennis.
And it's Libbi Gorr there with the Victorian Premier. Bob Carr, if I can ask you, how exhausting is an election campaign?
Oh, it's really, really tiring. A state election as much as a federal election. And as leader, you're a perfectionist. You want everything to go right. And I can tell you this, in an election campaign, not everything goes right. There's a stuff up every day.
Do you get weary of being friendly and happy with everyone?
No, the thing that wears you down is the media, the querulous media.
Oh,
media.
Oh, oh,
The people are lovely. They give you a lot of support, a lot of good feedback.
No, but as a former journalist, exactly. Watch your mouth out.
Yeah, well, there's no way around this, but it's a battle with the media. That's what an election campaign is. Well, it's the beat-ups and the distractions. And the media always...
Because we're holding a candle to democracy, I think, is what you're
saying. Exactly. You do that, but you're very much focused on process rather than substance.
Do you ever get sore, like, cheek muscles from all the smiling?
Yeah, that's a phenomenon, and you wear out your hand shaking hands, yeah.
What about how do you feel about poor old Denis Napthine? Because he got parachuted in after this ridiculous sort of palace coup against Ted Baillieu. You were the last of the New South Wales premiers to actually spend a decent amount of time in the job. You won three elections.
Yeah.
Is the revolving door leadership style of backroom politics killing the political system?
I think it's very bad, and I'd like to think that politicians on both sides have learnt the lesson from these too frequent changes of leadership. You've got to give the public time to assess you, and you've got to give yourself time to, you've got to give your leader time to find his or her way in the job. And the public got very puzzled when the guillotine came down and Kevin Rudd was executed and Julia brought on. They thought, what was wrong here? Why did you have to do this? It looks suspicious. And I think both sides have learnt their lesson about too frequent changes.
I think the public also thinks if you can't run your own party, how can you run your own country?
Yeah, well, that's a taunt you never want to have thrown at you in politics. If this mob can't run themselves, how can they aspire to run the country or the state? That's devastating.